Hey guys, today I want to show you how to do the Affliction Warlock Challenge for the Mage Tower very easily. For talents, it all abounds absolute corruption talent for the last phase. Other talents don't have that great of an impact, but however, I still recommend to take Inevitable Demise to have an easier time with the hands, Demon Skin or Burning Rush. Burning Rush is probably better, but I just like my comfort pick of Demon Skin. Phantom Singularity to just have another instant dot to cast by moving. Mortical to fear the wasp, but Hole of Tower is also good. Haunt, just again to have another dot for the first phase. And Dark Soul Misery to do a little bit more burst damage for the first two phases. So you have a shorter amount of time to AFK at the end. So here at the start you have to bring in below 35%. I recommend to not use any CDs, keep all the CDs available for the caster boss in the middle. And never attack with your pet, only interrupt. So once Karan reaches 35%, the middle boss is gonna be attackable. You can pump all your CDs into him, except Dark Lair, as this might cause the boss to reset in a later phase. So once the caster in the middle gets immune again, Kevin will get attackable again. This time we also really get some hands which we have to interrupt and kill. Just use your Fey Hunter to interrupt them, dot them up while moving, and usually they die before they get the second cast through with your dots. For the second nuke phase, I should have waited a little bit longer since my CDs were not ready. I used drums and potions here, but absolutely not needed. Just will give you about 1 or 2 minutes less on AFKing at the end. Now we will also get Rune of Summoning, which we can easily soak with our pet. Have the pet move to action binded and move the pet right into the middle. The boss in the middle will no longer get immune, however Karim will come back eventually and we have to deal with the hands and the portals. I will forward it a bit until Karim is at 10%. So now that Karim is almost 10%, we will have to get away from the boss about at least 40 yards, so whenever Karim dies, that we are not in range. But make sure that corruption is up on the caster boss, because that will be our only damage. Now that Karim died, the boss is enraging and doing 500% more damage, which would eventually kill us if we do the boss legend. I'm waiting for him to kill my pet, but however he will still cast Rune of Summoning. And we still have to deal with all the adds he summoned. We will also get one thing of nightmare from the very first rune, but it shouldn't be a problem since we can just banish it and it will eventually despawn. The add comes, getting ready for my banish. Even if he hits you once or twice at the start, he doesn't hurt that much, but make sure to banish him quickly. Now it's time to finish all the adds. Jump down this ledge here and run in circles, kill all the adds. Make sure they don't hit you. So once you're on the ledge here, the Fangs of Nightmare will no longer reach you and they evade and despawn. For me it was about 2% per minute that corruption did as damage. And that's it! You're gonna AFK for like 20 more minutes and the boss will eventually die. Enjoy! Did you know that over 180% of you guys are not subscribed? Let's make it 190%.